The initial goal for AACR Project GENIE was to leverage our unique standing as the most scientifically prestigious cancer research organization to create a pan-cancer registry through data sharing among leading national and international cancer institutions. Our vision is to accelerate the pace of advances in cancer precision medicine for the benefit of patients everywhere.
The sort of beginnings of the idea of AACR Project GENIE were probably in the early 2000s when I, as a physician, was taking care of patients with different leukemias and saw dramatic responses with targeted therapy. The next step was to try to include in the diagnostic workup of patients sequencing of their tumors, something that we now think of as routine today, but literally as early as just 20 years ago, that was a very foreign concept. There was a breakthrough moment technologically in the field with the development of next-gen sequencing. That suddenly changed the game. I was aware that at least 8 to 10 cancer centers were doing this, and I could see that each one was going to discover one little small thing, but if we pooled our efforts and shared our data, we'd find bigger patterns.
So we started out as 8 institutions that came together at an initial meeting in Philadelphia in 2014 to sort of plan the project and lay the initial seeds. And that's grown now to include more than 220,000 genomic records from almost 200,000 patients across institutions in North America as well as Europe. And now we have a site in Asia as well.
The biggest shift happened with the increasing recognition that we needed richer clinical annotation of the genomic samples. So in order to ask patient-relevant research questions about the relationship between genomics, treatments, and outcomes, we actually also need the data on the treatments and the outcomes. The genomics alone don't always fulfill that need.
When we collect the clinical data, we can find out the outcome. And in several cases, the mutation is in a protein for which there is a drug, but was approved for some other indication and was never thought to be relevant, where the patient with the rare mutation has gotten the off-label drug. The outcome was recorded as either positive or negative through GENIE and then used to then guide the treatment of other patients who subsequently are found to have that alteration.
For me, as an oncologist, meeting with patients every day and helping them make treatment decisions, I think I recognized, you know, many years ago that there was a big evidence gap in our knowledge. When we would get back some of these types of mutation reports, and patients would always ask me, you know, doc, what does this mean for me? And so I think GENIE has helped fill in the gaps of some of those conversations that I have with patients. We know a lot more about what different genomic alterations mean and how they may impact treatment decisions around drug therapies or patient outcomes.
In the coming 5 years, we've been thinking very strongly about how do we really support and make a larger impact on the rare cancer space. Our first foray would be to think about some drugs that are already on the market, and then we see similar variants or mutations in these rare cancers. Are we able to easily get regulatory approval or label expansion for those rare cancers?
We also want to increase and have more genomic representation from underserved groups. That's something that we've been working hard to try and increase the representativeness of the registry by bringing on more sites, by having targeted efforts to try and reach some of these populations that historically have been underrepresented in large data sharing initiatives.
As the CEO of AACR, I am immensely proud that AACR Project GENIE has made such major contributions to the science of precision medicine in just 10 years. The staunch commitment of AACR Project GENIE to provide open, fully accessible data has created a remarkable public utility for the global cancer research community.